Hi all. Welcome to the second part of the second chapter, Any Woman by Katherine Tyner. In the last session, we learned that mother is an indispensable part of a family. She has always proved her multifaceted talent in everything, right from support, warmth, love, to tethering. Any woman is, of course, a creation of a tender heart which aches silently for the suffering of women. The lines are deep and sorrowful. It reminds us of our mother, sisters, wife and daughters, if any. After the hours of tedious hard work, they come to us with a smiling, pleasant face. Without waiting much, let's move on to the fifth stanza.
Now, the fifth stanza. I'm the house from floor to roof. I deck the walls, the board I spread, I spin the curtains warp and woof and shake the down to be their bed. The new word in this stanza is warp and woof. When you weave a fabric, the thread runs lengthwise, that is warp, and crosswise, that is woof. The first line, deck the walls, means mother decorates the wall, or in other words, she herself is a decoration on the wall. Board I spread indicates that mother provides meal and often lodging. I spin the curtains warp and woof means she lays foundation of privacy by spinning curtains warp and woof and shake the down to be her bed. Here, shake the down is an image drawn from animal life. It indicates that just like the mother bird shakes its fine feathers to prepare bed for its offspring, the mother sacrifices her desires and pleasure for the family. I don't know whether you might have noticed the mother hen shaking herself and helping the chickens stay safe and comfortable. This is the self-effacing love of your mother, humble and making herself unnoticeable. Multifaceted tasks by decorating, taking care of health, by providing food, cleaning, giving them privacy and comfort is well depicted here in this stanza. Now, the last stanza. And their wall against all danger, their door against the wind and snow. Thou, whom a woman laid in a manger, take me not till the children grow. Wind and snow is symbolic of natural or man-made calamities. Woman or mother stands as a wall that safeguards a family from impending dangers and as a door against adversities and unpleasant situations. The poetess concludes the poem with a note of prayer to infant Jesus that every sincere mother always seeks from God not to take her away till the children grow. Thou refers to Jesus Christ, meaning you. Manger, this is where Jesus Christ was born, an allusion to the birth of infant Jesus. In her appeal to infant Jesus, the woman highlights the nobility of Virgin Mary, probably to highlight the role of mother.
The poet, knowingly or unknowingly, glorifies motherhood when she refers to the mother who laid in the manger. I think this poem is a gentle reminder for us all that there is no love in the world that can replace your mothers. After the quantum of work she does, the tedious task she does, she approaches us with a gentle smile. What is the quantum of work your mother does in the home? How do you support her? What is your behavior with her? Are you soft-spoken? All these questions reminds me of another poem, Middle Age by Kamala Das. It reveals how shockingly painful it is for a mother when she is neglected by her children. Middle age is when her children are no longer friends but critics, stern of face and severe with the tongue. According to Kamala Das, it's your attitude that decides your mother's age. So don't be stern with your face or severe with your tongue. Don't make her feel that you no longer need her. I think now you can relate this poem with any woman. You will have many such similar poems for the exam. either asking you to write a review or a critical appreciation. While writing this, it's enough that you keep in mind that the first paragraph should include the name of the poet, the name of the poem, the theme, and whether it's relevant in the contemporary society. The second paragraph should be the elaboration of the plot. The third paragraph should you have to point out the poetic devices and how it enhances the development of the plot. And the fourth is the conclusion, where you can give the message. I think now we have done with this chapter. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you very much.